I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny that when a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face, you get sprung. Wanna pull up tough cause you notice that butt was stuffed deep in the jeans she's wearing. I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh, baby, I wanna get with you and take your picture. My homeboys tried to warn me, but that butt you got makes me so horny.
Hey again, everyone. Today I'm going to be taking another look at the Coqui XTTS project to see where it stands in terms of capability and usability. This is going to be a brief run-through of how to fine-tune a single-speaker XTTS version 2 model if you find that you aren't getting good results with the base model, and I'll also go through a run of a multi-speaker XTTS version 2 model that you might have mixed results trying to train. The last time I used Coqui was when XTTS version 1 was released. There haven't really been many updates since then, as the company behind the project was shut down. So what does that mean for the open source offerings? Well, it's already showing a few signs of decay. The Coqui framework doesn't depend on too many obscure packages, but when components like NumPy are updated to new major versions, things tend to break. The project has been forked, and the new maintainers have done a great job of fixing up some of the bugs. That said, I still find Coqui to be a little bit frustrating. The documentation has improved a lot since its original release, but I feel like the project presented itself as a little too user-friendly for its own good. Many Coqui users were introduced to it through Google Colab. Since the release of Stable Diffusion, Google has clamped down on Colab sessions. Running Coqui trainers on Colab is doable, but you're on your own. If you spend a few minutes to learn the basics of Jupyter Notebooks and how Colab works, you can copy and paste together a Colab script and try this for yourself. Before I go into installing Coqui and training a model, I need to put together a couple datasets to test. There's no hard line in regard to the minimum dataset length, but I'd say that 10 minutes is probably on the edge of what may train well with XTTS, depending on what utterances were included in the dataset and the quality of the recording. Rather than spend time cutting out noises between words and breaths, I'll isolate the speech segments using the Label Sounds tool in Audacity. This will isolate sounds, leaving a slight trail to make sure the sounds are not clipped. Audacity's Label Sounds tool will also overlap samples if they're shorter than the minimum length. Open your track in Audacity and then select the track in the window and hit Ctrl plus A to select it all. Then open the Label Sounds dialog. Select a silence threshold at or below the noise floor of your audio track. That's the level of background or recording noise. Set a minimum silence threshold somewhere between the length of a comma pause and a period pause. I generally leave this around 0.35 seconds. The minimum label interval sets the minimum detected segment length. I leave this around 1.5 to 3 seconds. The leading and trailing silence are important, as leaving too long of a head or tail will usually include extra noise, mouth sounds, or other non-speech sounds. Setting this too short will result in unnaturally clipped speech. I think the general rule is to leave 0.1 seconds, but I tend to leave a lot more, and then trim the clips by hand after. I find this captures natural speech much better, and even allows models to spontaneously include breath sounds in longer passages. I tend to leave this about 0.2, 0.3 seconds. You can select each sample and hit play to preview the isolated clip. Name for the segments in the box down below, and then select a save destination. If any files have leading or trailing silence that's too long, you can use the a quick wave editor like Waveshop to trim them up. I suggest running the files through FFmpeg to convert them to single-channel 22,050Hz audio files to be used for training. After the audio files are made, curated, and trimmed, they could be transcribed using the Faster Whisper fork of OpenAI's Whisper. Faster Whisper can't coexist with Coqui XTTS due to conflicting requirements, so you'll need to create a separate conda environment for Faster Whisper and install from the master branch. To install Coqui, create a conda environment with Python 3.10, Git, and pip. Install PyTorch with CUDA using the command from the PyTorch installation page. Then clone the fork of Coqui XTTS from its GitHub repository. Change to the directory and install it with pip install -e, and then period in square brackets all dev and docs. Here's a quick Python script that will transcribe a directory of WAV files and write an output file called metadata.csv. This dataset follows the format of the popular open source dataset LJSpeech, and because of that we can use the LJSpeech data loader in the Coqui trainer. The LJSpeech metadata file has three columns separated by a pipe character. The first column is the path to the file without the file extension, the next is the transcript, and then the final column is what's normally called the normalized transcript. For the purposes of this video, the last two columns are identical. Read through the transcript when it's completed and fix any errors. I suggest retranscribing any triple digit or greater numbers due to variances in how they're spoken. Similarly, dollar amounts may need to be fixed if there's differences in how they're said. For example, a transcription containing dollar sign 100 could be $100, or $100, or $100. That transcript would be ambiguous, and those ambiguities may end up being errors and lead to a poor quality model.
$1,000,000.
Also review punctuation and try to be aware of the speaker's individual style. Place commas and periods in the transcript where the spoken word naturally sounds like they're being placed. Don't place them by default at the end of every sentence in the transcript if they weren't actual pauses in the speech. This will lead to inconsistent, stuttering speech in the
fine-tuned
model.
You died of dysentery. You give me the watch. I hid this uncomfortable hunk of metal up my ass.
To fine-tune the model, I'll take the basic Coqui XTTS version 2 training recipe and make a few tweaks. The file can be found in the Recipes LJSpeech folder. I have deviated slightly from the original script. First, I've disabled start with eval, lowered batch size to 2, and grad accumulation to 32. To configure the dataset on Windows, set the dataset name, path, and metafile path, and language code required. On Windows, you'll need to escape each slash by using double slashes. You won't need this for the initial training run, but to resume a training session, set the XTTS checkpoint to point to a path of a previous fine-tuning run. And again, you'll need to escape it with double slashes if you're on Windows. Set the speaker reference variable to point to an ideal example of the voice you're training. If you're on Windows, you'll need to use a wonky path name with the root directory escaped by double backslashes and the dataset path using single backslashes. I have no idea why this is the case, but any other structure throws an error on my system. For test sentences, I've added a few longer passages to test the voice during training. These sentences can be played back using TensorBoard. Launch TensorBoard with TensorBoard --logdir.run/training. Under load train samples, I've also set eval split to false, and in the trainer config, set run eval to false. Do evaluation if you want to, but I don't much care when I'm fine-tuning a well-trained model using a tiny dataset to generate one specific voice. Overall generalization will probably deteriorate, but that's a trade-off I'll make when I'm trying to get a specific voice for a task. You should hear reasonable quality output after a couple hundred steps, and the model's author says that a good fine-tuned speech should be attainable after 1-3 epochs. With a small dataset, I find that to really get a good representation of a voice, you'll probably need to go 30 or 50,000 steps, maybe more. It seems to be a long-tail problem. The model improves slower as training goes on. It'll appear to be overfitting, with the output repeating at the end of sentences. The repetition will slowly begin to move to the middle of the audio and then to the beginning, and then will kind of merge into the output. Continued training will probably give you a more rich-sounding voice. If you can manage to pull the model from training at the right point before it starts manufacturing new repetitions, that is. The only difference when training a multi-voice model is that you'll need to manually combine your voices into a single dataset or set up multiple datasets in the script as shown in the Coqui documentation. You'll also need to balance your voices so there is a similar quantity of samples of each voice. To generate samples with multiple voices for TensorBoard, duplicate the sample blocks in the trainer script and specify a new reference wave for each speaker. To load the model using the command line or the Python API, rename the checkpoint to model.pth and copy the tokenizer, vocab.json, melstats, and DVA from the original XTTS model files. Those are downloaded to the run directory and saved in the XTTS 2.0 original model files directory. To reduce the file size of the model from 5 GB to around 1.7 GB, you can remove the optimizer states. To do that, use something like this code snippet to load the model and save a slimmed down version. You'll need to rename the file to model.pth to load it with the standard Coqui APIs. The current community-supported Coqui fork seems to be going well, but I'm sure they could use some donations of time or talent if anyone can help out on the project. It looks like they're hoping to continue the roadmap and are hoping to add support for things like SSML in the future. There are also ongoing efforts to explore how fine-tuning other components of the XTTS model will affect the output. But it seems like simply training the GPT portion does a pretty good job of aligning the output. Selecting the correct representative audio sample is really important though. Different computed latents will alter the output, but this does open up the door for fun things like fusing voices or changing accents by using different samples matched with different voices.
Wouldn't you like to be a pepper too?
What is going on?
I don't know. It must be the print scanner. It must be reading it someplace.
I am not understanding that reference.
Be a pepper too.
That's about all I want to cover in this one. If you found it at all helpful, please leave a comment or a like. I'll probably be working on one more video after this one, expanding on how to use XTTS version 2 fine tunes in more practical areas. After that, I may step away from the channel for a while. The videos have been getting really poor viewership. YouTube doesn't want to give them impressions in the discovery system anymore. The few of you stumbling across them do it via the search box, and there's little I can do to change that. The videos have reasonable thumbnails, descriptions, closed captions, tags, and even backlinks from GitHub repos where my videos are linked on the front page, and my own site. YouTube just categorically refuses to show the videos I post to the correct audiences during the initial viewing period. That ruins the view metrics, and then the algorithm decides the videos are just spam trash. The only thing that will have an impact now is user interaction, so if you want the channel to stick around, let the algorithm know. Spending 30 hours working on a video that only 30 people watch is sort of silly. I may as well just give you all my phone number and walk you through things personally at that point. Anyways, enough ranting from me. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.
He's gone.